Mr. Chairperson, Director General, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to speak at this plenary session of the 22nd Conference of the States Parties to the Chemical Weapons Convention on behalf of Tehran Peace Museum and the Society for Chemical Weapons Victim Support, SCWES, Iran. Please allow me to begin by extending our appreciation to the Director General, Ambassador Ozumju. Since beginning his term of office at OPCW in 2010, this organization has succeeded in achieving its goals to a great extent. In specific, I would like to appreciate Ambassador Ozumju's efforts in supporting survivors of chemical warfare in different aspects. We hope that such approach and success would continue during the future administration of the OPCW. We also would like to thank the ongoing efforts of the Technical Secretariat of OPCW, as well as the States Parties in advancing the goals of the CWC during the last year. Excellencies, curated by SCWES, Tehran Peace Museum follows two important missions. First is to raise awareness about devastating impacts of wars and violence with a focus on the use of chemical weapons. And second is to promote a culture of peace and nonviolence. These goals are pursued through many different methods, including the permanent exhibitions of our museum, various workshops and educational programs, our Art for Peace Gallery, and our network of Iranian and non-Iranian partners. Our programs are designed for different target groups and we reach hundreds of ordinary people, youth, tourists, and delegations each year. What makes such programs unique is the active engagement of the survivors of chemical warfare in Tehran Peace Museum as the volunteer guides. Despite suffering from the long-term consequences of exposure to chemical warfare, these survivors narrate our exhibitions and share their life stories with our visitors, only to emphasize why a world free of chemical weapons matters. Through years, these volunteer guides have inspired hundreds of individuals, especially young people, and they continue to do so. We believe that as the most successful disarmament treaty, the CWC can be a solid role model for the treaty for the prohibition and the prohibition of nuclear weapons. But there is something to be learned from that treaty as well. The survivors of atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the Hibakushas, have been the face and the voice of advocacy for abolishment of nuclear weapons. We believe that there is even a great potential for that regarding CWC, and we encourage OPCW and States Parties to take that into their consideration. We at TPM are benefiting from this potential through our different projects, including recent oral history articles and documentaries. We hope that OPCW can expand its activities in this direction as well and hopefully assist us in our future projects, including the registration of all victims of chemical weapons. Mr. Chairperson, gladly today, the prohibition of use of chemical weapons in any forms by anyone is a very strong norm of the international community. Such norm requires all involved actors to work closely together in good faith. CWC must become a completely universal treaty with no more delay. In putting a stop to any future use of chemical weapons, all political considerations should be put aside, and all members of the international community should join hands rather than confrontation. We also believe that the ones who have used chemical weapons, especially in the recent conflicts, should be held accountable for their actions with no hesitation. At the end, I would like to invite Mr. Ali Jalali Farahani, a survivor of chemical weapons, to join me and share his remarks with you.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Khanam ha va aghayan. من در سال 1366 24 ساله بودم که در معرض گاز خردل قرار گرفتم به دلیل شرایط حادم بلافاصله برای درمان به ژاپن اعزام شدم.
In the name of God, ladies and gentlemen, I was exposed to mustard gas in 1988 when I was 24 years old. Due to my extraordinary condition, immediately after I was dispatched to Japan for treatment.
زمانی که 70 روز بعد در بیمارستانی در توکیو به هوش آمدم فهمیدم که لحظه تولد فرزندم را ندیدم و از آن پس لحظات زیاد دیگری را نیز به دلیل مجروحیت از دست دادم.
When I woke up 70 days later in a hospital in Tokyo, I realized that I haven't seen my first child's birth and I have missed many other great moments because of my injuries since then.
اما اگر قرار بر یادآوری باشد ترجیح می‌دهم خاطراتی را به یاد بیاورم که من را به آینده‌ای بهتر امیدوار می‌کند. عصری که در آن دیگر هیچ انسانی از سلاح شیمیایی رنج نخواهد برد.
But when I choose to recall memories, I prefer to refer to the ones that make me feel hopeful for a better future, an era in which no more human would suffer from chemical weapons.
من مهربانی کادر پزشکی ژاپنی را به یاد می‌آورم که ثابت کردند انسانیت قابل چشم‌پوشی نیست. گفتگوهایم را با جوانان زیادی به یاد می‌آورم که از من می‌پرسیدند سلاح شیمیایی چیست. و چرا نباید استفاده شود؟
I recall the kindness of the Japanese medical staff who proved humanity cannot be overlooked. I recall my conversations with many young people about what chemical weapons are and why they should not be used.
فکر کردن به همه این لحظات فوق‌العاده در مورد در موزه صلح تهران که به آگاهی بخشی سپری شده است باعث می شود احساس کنم که توانستم تغییری در جهان پیرامون خودم ایجاد کنم و این باعث افتخار من است.
Thinking about all the wonderful moments I have had at Tehran Peace Museum, raising awareness about chemical weapons, I feel I have made a change in the world and it fills me with pride.
بنابراین امروز که با شماهایی که نماینده های اکثریت ملت های دنیا هستید صحبت می کنم. آرزو می کنم که شما هم تمام توان خود را به کار بگیرید تا در پایان کار احساسی چون من داشته باشید.
So now talking to you, the ones who are representing all nations, I wish you can also do the best in your power so you would have the same feeling as me at the end of your work.
از توجه شما سپاسگزارم.
Thank you for your attention.